Hi, I'm Dr. Frederick Burley, President and CEO of COSI, and the host of QED with Dr. B. Now, join the animated me for Dr. B in three. Okay. So we're all obsessed with this thing called race. Well, what is race? Why are there different skin colors? And what does the science tell us? So let's just nip this in the bud, shall we? There is no scientific basis for the concept of race. Rather, race is a social construct developed to try to box people in certain groups for accounting purposes.
Yes, I said it.
There it is. Race is an invention, a fallacy, a ruse, and certainly not supported by science. Now, skin color, on the other hand? There's a perfectly scientific explanation for that. To understand different skin colors, though, you have to appreciate the concept of time, geography, and part of that good old sunshine, ultraviolet, or UV light. So here it is. About 150,000 years ago, us, Homo sapiens, popped up on our beloved planet. Not just anywhere though, right here. Yep, you guessed it, Africa, the origin of humanity. Gives a whole new meaning to who's your mama and who's your daddy, right? And the area of human origin was very close to the equator, where, amongst other things, the concentration of UV light is highest. Now, while some UV light is important for the body's synthesis of vitamin D, too much UV is harmful. It causes breaks in our DNA and can lead to that dreaded C word, cancer. So, to help protect us from the harmful effects of too much UV, we have this protein called melanin. Melanin is like a super dope sunscreen and is produced by these cells called melanocytes. The first humans, dark-skinned folks, have evolved to have more melanocytes and more of that awesome, super dope natural sunscreen, melanin. This is a clever evolutionary designed adaptation that took over tens of thousands of years to develop and allowed the first humans to better cope with the massive amounts of UV hitting you all day, every day in that geographic location. Now, you know us humans, restless as we cannot sit still. And around 60,000 years ago, some of them packed up their Louis Vuitton trunks and headed out of the tropics towards less sunny regions of the planet. Now, scientifically, the further you are from the tropics, the less UV you get exposed to. And through a slow process of selective mutation, the next adaptation was a depigmentation of skin, i.e. getting lighter. You developed less melanocytes and produced less melanin, and therefore evolved lighter skin. So skin color is a litmus test or surrogate for ancestral UV exposure. Again, this took tens of thousands of years. That tan you got from that 1 week trip to Jamaica ain't gonna cut it. You will fade right back to your original self. Mother Nature does have a sense of humor. But here's the thing. The difference in skin color does not a race make. Skin color is like a color spectrum. Can you categorically decide where red ends and orange begins? Where green ends and blue begins? Nope, can't do it. And that's the same with skin tones and colors. In fact, because Africans were on the planet longer than any other population, they have accumulated more genetic mutations. They have aged longer. And like the growing complexity of an aging wine or scotch, they have more mutations amongst themselves than anyone else. In fact, there are African communities that have more genetic variation amongst themselves than between African and European or African and Asian populations. Yes, some white people are more similar at the DNA level to some black people than they are to other white people. There you have it. We are all cousins. In fact, all of us humans on this planet are 99.9% identical at the genetic level. That means 0.1% is what makes up the difference between me and you. So to close, there's no scientific basis for race. It's a fabricated social construct. Of course, there are biological differences, but there are biological differences between you and your brother, you and your sister, or parent, or your neighbor. And they may all be the same race as you. Now, even though race may be a social construct, the experience it creates is unquestionably tangible. You see, these arbitrary boxes created to categorize populations have very real impacts on very real people. But because we humans built the boxes, we are the ones who have the power to deconstruct them. In fact, there is only one race, and that's the human race. Puts a whole new perspective on the idea of racism, right? Yeah, we need to squash that for so many reasons, but especially for the science of it. And that's another Dr. B in 3.
If you like this video, remember to like, subscribe, and comment below.